Believe it or not, Sierra Space is about to launch Dream Chaser into orbit, SpaceX's latest Starlink launch. Before we begin, a quick reminder. Some of our members have mentioned that they're not receiving notifications for our new uploads. To help resolve this, please take a moment to like this video, ensure the notification bell is turned on, and finally double check that you're subscribed to our community. Your time and attention to this matter are greatly appreciated, and I want you all to stay connected with us. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. Hello and welcome back. If you're a space enthusiast like me, you're probably aware of the exciting developments happening at Sierra Space. Lately, their Dream Chaser spaceplane has been making waves in the space industry, and I've been keeping a close eye on their progress since the beginning of this year. Today, we'll be taking a deep dive into the latest updates on this ambitious project. We'll discuss where Sierra Space stands currently, what's next on their agenda, and a possible launch timeline. So, let's get started. Sierra Space's Dream Chaser spaceplane is edging closer to its inaugural mission to the International Space Station, ISS, with a scheduled launch in the third or fourth quarter of 2024. However, you know, before it can embark on its journey, the spacecraft must complete two significant tests and undergo final preparations at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. The Dream Chaser has been in development for over 15 years, with the current iteration beginning in 2016 when NASA awarded a commercial cargo contract to Sierra Nevada, Sierra Space's parent company. This mission will be the first of seven resupply missions to the ISS under the NASA contract. A second reusable spaceplane is also under construction to meet NASA's requirements and potentially serve as future commercial space stations. After undergoing environmental testing at NASA's Neil Armstrong Test Facility in Ohio since December, the Dream Chaser is ready to be transported to the Kennedy Space Center. The testing in Ohio included shock tests to check the spacecraft's response to the jolt of separation from the Vulcan rocket in orbit, vibration tests to simulate launch vibrations, and thermal vacuum testing to subject the spacecraft to the extreme temperatures and airless environment of low Earth orbit for 5 weeks. Sierra Space CEO Tom Weiss hailed the successful completion of environmental testing as a significant milestone, marking the transition from research and development to regular orbital operations. Successful completion of an incredibly rigorous environmental testing campaign in close partnership with NASA is a significant milestone and puts Dream Chaser on track for operations later this year, Weiss said. This is the year that we transition from rigorous research and development to regular orbital operations and, in doing so, transform the way we connect space and Earth. Before launch, the Dream Chaser must undergo heat shield completion, acoustic testing, electromagnetic interference and compatibility testing, and cargo loading. The spaceplane and its attached Shooting Star cargo module will be loaded with cargo, and the spacecraft will be fueled with propellant for its maneuvering thrusters. The heat shield, in particular, requires careful attention, as it will protect the spacecraft during re-entry into Earth's atmosphere. While Sierra Space aims to launch the Dream Chaser in the third or fourth quarter of 2024, the exact date depends on the completion of remaining tests and preparations. The company must also work with NASA to find an opening in the ISS's manifest of visiting vehicles. Additionally, Sierra Space must obtain a re-entry license from the Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, which recently announced it will no longer allow commercial re-entry vehicles to launch before obtaining regulatory approval to return to Earth. The Dream Chaser will fly on the second launch of United Launch Alliance's ULA Vulcan rocket, which had a successful inaugural flight in January. ULA officials initially aimed to launch the second Vulcan rocket in April, but the Dream Chaser wasn't ready, and neither was Vulcan, as ULA waited for delivery of the rocket's second BE-4 main engine from Blue Origin. ULA and its primary customer, the US Space Force, are eager to launch the second Vulcan rocket as soon as possible to demonstrate the rocket's performance and reliability before launching pricey military payloads. If the Dream Chaser's schedule slips further, ULA has a backup plan to launch another mission, either a commercial payload or a dummy satellite. ULA CEO Tory Bruno emphasized that the company aims to launch Vulcan again in the fall, as soon as Dream Chaser is ready. However, ULA won't wait indefinitely for the spaceplane, ensuring that the Vulcan rocket certification flights stay on track. As the Dream Chaser spaceplane approaches its maiden voyage, Sierra Space and its partners are working diligently to complete the remaining tests and preparations. While challenges and uncertainties remain, the finish line is in sight, and the potential for a launch in the fall is promising. The successful deployment of the Dream Chaser will mark a significant milestone in the development of commercial space stations and the transformation of space exploration. The Dream Chaser's reusable design and ability to carry cargo and crew make it an attractive option for future space missions. Its development has also spawned innovation in areas like thermal protection systems and advanced materials. As the space industry continues to evolve, the Dream Chaser is poised to play a crucial role in shaping the future of space exploration and commerce. I'm absolutely thrilled to see the Dream Chaser spaceplane nearing operational status, and I wish the Sierra Space team all the best in their missions. While it's often referred to as a mini shuttle and draws comparisons to NASA's iconic shuttle system, the Dream Chaser's sleek design and futuristic aesthetic make it look like something straight out of a science fiction movie. And I mean that in the best possible way. Also, what's your opinion on the Dream Chaser? Do you prefer Dream Chaser or SpaceX's Dragon Capsule and Falcon 9 combo? I really want to know your thoughts. Don't wait, comment down now itself. Now let's discuss about the latest Starlink launch by SpaceX. On May 8th, SpaceX achieved another milestone in its ambitious Starlink program, launching 23 additional satellites into low Earth orbit from Launch Complex 39A at Kennedy Space Center in Florida. The launch, initially scheduled for 11 a.m. ET, was delayed until the end of the launch window, finally taking off at 2:42 p.m. ET. Just over an hour after launch, the 23 Group 6, 56 V2 mini Starlink satellites were deployed into a 43-degree orbital inclination, matching the trajectory of all previous Group 6 missions. This deployment brings the total number of Starlink satellites in space to 6,373, further expanding SpaceX's rapidly growing constellation. The Falcon 9 rocket used for this mission was Booster 1083, flying for the third time. This experienced booster has previously launched Crew 8 and another Starlink mission. Its next mission may be particularly notable, as Polaris Dawn mission commander Jared Isaacman has expressed interest in using Booster 1083 for their upcoming mission. This could involve launching a crew of four to perform a commercial spacewalk and test SpaceX's new extravehicular activity suit. After completing its mission, Booster 1083 made a smooth landing on the drone ship, a short fall of gravitas. The booster will now be transported back to Port Canaveral, where it will be offloaded and undergo refurbishment in preparation for its next launch. This launch marks SpaceX's 47th mission of the year and fourth of the month, demonstrating the company's commitment to maintaining a rapid launch pace. With a goal of achieving 148 launches in a calendar year, SpaceX is pushing the boundaries of space technology and exploration. Overall, this successful launch and deployment of 23 additional Starlink satellites brings SpaceX closer to its goal of providing global internet connectivity through its satellite constellation. As the company continues to innovate and expand its capabilities, we can expect even more exciting developments in the world of space exploration and technology. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.